Here's my answer. First, I defined all the ranks. That had been a constant that we had in the program before, but I'm going to have to refer to it a couple times, so I called it out and gave it a name. Then I defined all the red cards and all the black cards. Those are what we're going to substitute for the various jokers. And then here's best wild hand. So what I did is I said, let's apply this function replacement to each of the cards in hand. Here's what replacement does. Replacement takes a card and replaces comes up with a list of possibilities for that card. So if the card is a black joker, then it can be replaced with all the black cards. If the card is a red joker, it can be replaced with all the red cards. And otherwise, it can be replaced only with itself. And we'll make that a list because the interface here is that you give me one card and I give you a list of all the cards it can be replaced with. Now, what am I doing here? This looks a little bit tricky. What I'm saying is I'm calling innertools.product. Let me explain to you what product does. So the product function takes a list takes any number of lists, or in fact they can be iterables. And here we're just going to try 2. So the product of 1, 2, 3, and 100, 200. Product stands for cross product, so we'd have all ways of taking one item from this list and one item from this list. So that would return a list, and the pairs of items are put into tuples. So it would be 1, 100, 1, 200, 2, 100, 2, 200, 3, 100, 3, 200. So however many lists it's given, it picks out one element from each, puts that into a tuple, and does that for every possible combination of elements from A, B, and whatever else there is there. So what we've done here is we've called replacement on each card in the hand, and that gives us a list of possibilities for each of the cards. If the card's not a joker, that list will be 1. If the card is a joker, then it will be all the red cards or all the black cards. So now we have the product of that. So for all the 7 cards in the hand, we've got this big product, and we go through and we take all the possibilities, and then for each one of those possibilities, H, we pick out the best hand using the process that we did before, and that gives us a set of possible hands, and then we go through those hands using hand rank. These hands are now the 5 card hands determined by best hand, and we take the maximum again according to hand rank, and that gives us the best out of those 5 cards. Now, for both of these solutions to the homework problems, I was able to come up with a small amount of code because I knew about existing routines in the standard Python library. And if you didn't know about those routines, and if you wrote a lot of lines of code rather than just 1 or 2, don't feel bad. You got the practice doing that, and I'm sure your code was good and did the right job, so you should feel proud that you got it working. But you should also learn this lesson, that you should try to familiarize yourself with the tools that already exist and use them when appropriate.